Hello, my name is Christian and I'm working as a software developer at Image Engineering. In this screencast I would like to show you how to visualize and compare the results of calculated images in the iQ-Analyzer. After you have processed some images, small icons will indicate whether the analysis is successful or not. Green check symbols represent a successful analysis, red X symbols an error. Gray icons are images which aren't calculated because they have been attached to the list recently. If you click on the images with a red or gray symbol, the iQ-Analyzer tells you that no results are available for this image. As we want to talk about the displaying of the results, we don't need them. First of all, it's good to check if the ROIs are placed correctly. You can do so by switching to the image with the Image Results toggle button. You see a lot of ROIs placed on this test chart, but this depends on the setting you've made. The ROI label can be shown by clicking the plus icon on each ROI. You can hide them by clicking on the name again. So in some modules it won't be necessary because there's enough space to display them all the time. So this detection looks fine, so let's switch back to the results. Clicking on images with a green check symbol automatically show the default graph, as seen here in the overview. All other graphs can be accessed by the pop-up menus below the main graph panel. So I'll just switch through some of them. Naturally, they differ a little bit from module to module. If you want to compare the results of different images, the iQ-Analyzer offers two methods. The first method is to open up to four separate graphs which individually display the chosen graph. Just click the plus button to add a new graph panel. The active graph is indicated by a blue frame. The first thing to do to show a new graph is always activate the panel. Then choose a file and then choose a view. You can do this with different images or with the same image but different graph styles. Each of these graphs are independent, at least with some exceptions. The second method is only available with some graphs, for example with the MTF group plot. These three images were taken with the different focal lengths of the zoom camera. To see which focal length scores the best result at MTF 10%, you can plot them all together in one graph. Now it's very easy to compare the different behaviors on the MTF curves. You see there are a lot of good ways to display and visualize your results and methods to compare them. Thanks for watching, and if you have any further questions on this software or the software in general, please visit our website and contact our support team. Bye!